It's Mike.
It's Danny.
It's Uwe.
It's Steve.
And we're Landmark, and you're watching
Live Frog.
Hey there, Marshall Husser here from Live Frog. It is time to bring you the first review of 2014. In this review, I have for you this album, Strange Attractors by Fractal Mirror. Fractal Mirror is a Dutch-American band. Hey, Dutch-American, how do these guys get in touch with each other? Well, that's probably the Strange Attractors, you know, you don't know from where they come. A group of friends were making music back in the 80s already. Just for fun, nothing serious like releasing an album or something, but just making some songs together. Then we fast forward to present day. Well, not present day, but an undetermined time ago. When these recordings were discussed by two of these musicians in the Big Big Train Facebook group. And at a certain point, someone from America, Frank Urbaniak, joined in the conversation and said, you know guys, I am a drummer and I would be more than happy to help you out with making some music. So they teamed up together and they formed the band Fractal Mirror. And Strange Attractors is their first release.
The morning comes and you are so far away. Surrounded by sound. Decisions you...
It was introduced to me by a friend who said, you know, this is the album of the year 2013. Now, when they say that, I always become a little bit mean, because then I say, okay, if you say that is the album of the year, well, it's got to be something special. So I want to know, I want to test it myself. Well, I have the opportunity, as you can see, I have the album in my hand. I can show it to you. Here we have the album with some artwork and the rear with the tracks. But before I tell you what my impression of this album is, there's one little fun fact I need to mention about this band. Because one of the members, Leo Koperdraad, used to be a reviewer himself. He used to review for Dutch progressive rock pages, started in 2007, and he stopped reviewing, well, last year, 2013. So for 6 years, he has been a reviewer himself. Now, he is on the other side, because he is now being reviewed with his music. Must be a very weird feeling. Okay, enough of that. Back to the music. Now, I was really interested in listening to this album. And the first spin I gave, I gotta be honest, I wasn't overly impressed. But I listened to the album again. And I thought, hey, this sounds better. Yeah, this sounds quite nice, actually. And then I played the album again. And I thought, I kind of like that. Yeah, it's a great atmosphere in there. So after a couple of spins, you know, the more I played the album, the more I started to enjoy what I was hearing. The overall sound is a bit hard to describe. I mean, it is not prog, but it has a lot of progressive elements in it. There are really nice keyboards in it. There are nice guitars in it. I have to say, I really like the drums on the album. I really enjoyed that very much when I was listening to the album. So that's very good. And then I was checking the biography of the band on their website. And there they mentioned David Sylvian as being, back in the 80s, being an inspiration to them. And that's, you know, that's when it kind of struck me, you know, that is the atmosphere and that is the influence I really pick up on this album. But I couldn't just put a name to it, and by that reference I knew it. That is the kind of sound you find on this album. But still, that doesn't do it enough justice. You really need to listen to it and then you will understand what kind of a sound this band brings. But it is not, you know, something you just describe in one word or even in one sentence. And when you can do that, that makes an album interesting to listen to. And that's what I said when I started to listen to the album a few more spins. I started to pick up on more different influences, more details in the music, and that's when it got interesting. And after a few spins, I had to realize I can only make one conclusion. These guys really know how to make good songs because they make them very interesting. And each time you listen, you hear something new and you hear something different. This album really grows on you. And after a couple of spins, I had to say, I really like what I'm hearing. I still wouldn't call this album of the year, given, you know, the many albums I have heard, but this is definitely a very interesting album and very good to listen to. It is also a relatively short album. There are 10 tracks and it is about 41 minutes, so it's not a long album. And the track listing is divided in an A and a B, so you get the idea of a vinyl. You know, I always like it when they do that because, you know, that gives the whole idea of listening more depth. I still find listening to a physical medium the best way to listen to music, rather than just a digital download. Cold and everything.
He is done. He is done. He is done.
A couple of details that I found out when I listened to the album. They bring some really nice atmospheres on the album, but sometimes they're just a tad dark with a little of melancholy in it. But it's a very calm album, you know. Don't expect any really heavy rocks, anything, or outbursts, or solos, or anything. Now they keep it, you know, they keep it nice and quiet. And especially the first two tracks, when you were listening to them, you really get that really relaxed feeling that you know, you listen to these beautiful songs. And then comes track number 3, Brian's Song, which is the longest track on the album. It's 5 minutes and 40 seconds long. And wow, that kind of shatters your rest a little bit, because that is, at least in the opening, a lot heavier with some more guitars, a bit of an edge to it, so they really stand out. The song has also really nice keyboards on it. There are some effects used on a vocal that completely make it stand out. And maybe when you listen to that first two tracks, you think, oh yeah, this is quite nice. And then you got that shock moment when that third track comes in. And again, you know, I said it before, I say it again. That is something I like. When you make a sudden move that will put the listener back on the edge of his seat listening to, whoa, what are they doing now? That is what this band is doing on a couple of moments, and they're doing it very good. And that makes an album interesting to listen to. The vocals, yeah. I'll first tell you the lineup, and then we go into the vocals a little bit. I already mentioned Leo Koperdraad. He is the vocalist on the album. He also plays guitars and keyboards. Ed van Hagen, bass, also keyboards and programming. And then we have the American part of this album, Frank Urbaniak, doing drums and percussion. The artwork has to be mentioned that you see here is done by Brian Watson. He also did a lot of artwork on the latest Tangent album, Le Sacre du Travail. You know, another up-and-coming artist that more and more musicians find and use his work in their album artwork, which is very nice. There are also two kind of guest performances, Don Fast doing ghost guitar and Charlotte Koperdraad doing also some vocals. And then we go back to that vocalist that I mentioned, Leo Koperdraad. I mean, vocals are always a bit of a delicate subject, because they are very much according to your taste. And that can be a lot different. And I always say vocals can make or break an album. I mean, the music can be really fantastic, but if you have a terrible vocalist or a vocalist that you don't like, you know, you don't like to listen to the album. So in that case, I have to be honest and I say that he has a really characteristic voice. A bit monotonous at times. I missed the sparkle a little bit. But I also learned in many reviews that I did that, of course, you know, you have a certain voice you're given with, and, you know, if you decide to be the singer, that's the voice you use. So in a way, you know, that is the choice the band made. Again, you know, after a couple of spins, I started to fit the voice and the music better together, and I started to appreciate a little bit more. So after a while, I kind of like the whole sound of the band, including the vocals. I mean, he has a voice that stands out, which is in a way good for the album. So you know, it gives the band really their own sound. You don't say, ah, oh, he sounds like, you know, Gabriel or Wilson or whatever we do. No, he really sounds like himself. He sounds like Leo Koperdraad. And that is the charm of this album. As I mentioned, these moments when you think, what are they doing now? You also have that when one song moves into the other. But for example, Insects is a really soft and very nice and gentle song. And when that ends and Raising the Stakes starts, again, you get this little jolt, like, whoa, you got some guitars there, heavy, and you get this jump again. And you're back, you know, with your attention to the music. So I like that when they do that in a couple of moments. Another track that stood out for me was Various Methods of Hunting. That's an instrumental track, which had a bit of an ambient sound. It had mainly keyboards in it and drums. I really enjoyed the atmosphere that song brings. You know, again, a song that stands out a little bit between the other songs, but a very beautiful song at that. So, you know, there's a lot more, of course, to discover, but you have to listen to the album for yourself. I really find this an album that grows with every spin. You know, the more you listen to it, the more you now see, piece all the pictures together, and you finally realize that, you know, it is a bit of a strange attraction towards this album. So therefore, I say I give this album a solid 8. Definitely worth to check out. It's a very good album. It already got a lot of praise, so a lot of people are really enjoying it. Well, if you haven't picked up on Fractal Mirrors yet, here's your chance. Check them out, because, well, as I said, it is a very good album, but you have to give it some time. The end. Fractal Mirror, Strange Attractors, an interesting album. Have you heard it already? What do you think of it? Do you like it or do you not like it? Leave a comment on my YouTube channel and let me know. And while you're there, click on the subscribe button so you can stay up to date on all the new videos I will be uploading. Of course, you can visit my website, lifeprog.com, and you can follow me on Facebook and Twitter. And I hope you will see me at a new review.